Well, good afternoon students, welcome back to online mathematics class. So in the last class we have completed the exercise 9.1. In today's class let us move on to the next topic, that is arithmetic progression. In short we call it as AP. So this you have already studied in your 10th standard, and let us discuss about the definition of an AP. What is the exact definition of an arithmetic progression? See here, a sequence a1, a2, a3 and so on, an and so on, is called an arithmetic sequence or an arithmetic progression if the condition is an plus 1, which is equals to an plus d, where n belongs to the natural numbers and a1 is the first term and d is going to be the common difference. So let me write the definition. So here, a sequence a1, a2, a3 and so on, an and so on. So this sequence is called an arithmetic sequence or arithmetic progression. Is called an arithmetic sequence. An arithmetic progression. Arithmetic progression. If the condition is an plus one, which is equals to an plus d. Is that clear? So an plus one is the next term of an. So to get the next term, you have to add the common difference to the previous term. So that's what the definition says. If an plus 1 equal to an plus d, then here the small n is nothing but the natural number. N belongs to capital N, where a1 is the first term, where a1 is the first term, where a1 is the first term. Here a1 is the first term and d, that is the constant term, is called the common difference, and the constant term d is called the common difference of the AP. The common difference. So now this is the definition of an arithmetic progression, and we have already studied that a2 minus a1 equal to a3 minus a2, which is equals to a4 minus a3 and so on. That difference must be same. So now what is the standard form of an AP? It is a plus d, a plus 2d, a plus 3d and so on. So now in the next line, the standard form of an AP is given by, so what is the standard form now? a plus d, and then a plus 2d and so on, like this it continues. This is the standard form of an arithmetic progression, and we have also studied that the nth term or the general term of an AP is an equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So that point we have to write now. The nth term also called as general term antunu heltivare idaka, अथवा लास्ट टर्म अंत हेत स्मॉल एल दिंदनु रिप्रेजेंट मार्तर और द जनरल टर्म द एंथ टर्म ऑफ एन एपी इज ऑफ एन एपी इज व्हाट इज दैट एन विच इज इक्वल्स टू ए प्लस एन माइनस वन इंटू डी वेर an is the nth term or the general term and a is the first term, n number of terms and d is the common difference. So this is regarding the nth term of an AP. And what is the sum to n terms of an AP? Sn, which is equals to n by 2, 2a plus n minus 1 into d. That also we have studied. The sum to n terms, n terms of an AP, the sum to n terms of an AP is what is that? Sn which is equals to n by 2 into the bracket 2a plus n minus 1 into d. 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So now this can also be written as, see here. So here Sn equal to n by 2, in place of 2a I can write a plus a, 2a can be written as a plus a, and then write the remaining term as it is, plus n minus 1 into d, plus n minus 1 into d. So here denote this as small l, andre idanu small l endanu no baribodu, andre an andre small l antanu barithu now. Then so here this a plus n minus 1 into d is nothing but the nth term or the general term or the last term of an AP. So here overall Sn equal to n by 2 a plus an or a plus l. So this can also be written as, we can also write it as, we can also write it as Sn which is equals to n by 2 a plus small l, n by 2 a plus l. This is how we write the sum to first n terms of an arithmetic progression. So this is all about the introduction of AP. Hope you are understanding this. Then we'll move on to arithmetic mean atho samantara madhya ante helthivaru. So that we are going to study now. Well, the next subtopic, it is arithmetic mean or AM of the two numbers. So let us go for the definition of an arithmetic progression, and we have an important example problem on this concept, and we will solve that after the definition. So here the definition is going to be, given two numbers a and b, small a small b, given two numbers a and b. So we can insert a number capital A between these two, so that, see here, we can insert a number, we can insert a number capital A between them, so that A comma capital A comma B, A comma B is an arithmetic progression. Such a number is called the arithmetic mean of the two numbers. See here, such a number A is called the arithmetic mean or the AM
is called the arithmetic mean of the two numbers A and B, two numbers A and B. So here we have capital A minus A, which is equals to then B minus A. So how did you write this? See here he says the two numbers, that is small a and small b, there are two numbers andre erdu number idare a mattu b anta hele ive erdu number madhye one number navu insert martu andre one number place martu ille yadu yav number ri capital A. So whenever you are inserting a number, so it should form an arithmetic progression. You yav number insert martiralla number insert madid mele aa mooru number en irbekri ap da irbekagtadu. So that's what he says, so that we can insert a number A then them, so that AAB is an arithmetic progression andre idu enabekavu AP agbekre, then such a number A is called the arithmetic mean of the two numbers. So illi idu A1 agtada, idu A2 agtada, idu A3 agtada, hadre. So in an arithmetic progression we know that second term minus the first term, A2 minus A1, that's what I have written here. So here it is A2 minus A1, which is equals to A3 minus A2, andre B minus A agbakri, B minus A, that's what I have written. Is that clear? Heng bardive artha agidare? Then, so now let us simplify this. Take minus A to the, yeah, let's say it becomes plus A, overall it becomes A plus A, which is equals to take minus small a to the RHS, it becomes plus a plus b. Now a plus a, it is 2a, this is equals to a plus b. Now a, which is equals to a plus b divided by 2, this is how we find the arithmetic mean of the two numbers. For example, what is the arithmetic mean of the two numbers a and b? Here, so for example, find the AM of two numbers 4 and 16. So now, so here 4 is a small a and 16 is a small b. So what is the capital A now? A plus b by 2, 4 plus 16 divided by 2, that will be 10. So here if you go for the solution, given a which is equals to 4 and b which is equals to 16, then am arithmetic mean a which is equals to a plus b divided by 2. So capital A which is equals to 4 plus 16 divided by 2, so a which is equals to it is 10. So now this number 10 you can insert between 4 and 16 so that it forms an AP. See here 4 10 16 ಬರಿ ಬೋದ್ರಿ ಈ ತರ. ಈಗ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಈಗ ಎ ಟು ಮೈನಸ್ ಎ ಒನ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು ಎ ತ್ರೀ ಮೈನಸ್ ಎ ಟು ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಚೆಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ರಿ. 10 - 4 ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 6 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ 16 - 10 ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 6 ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಬರ್ತದೆ ರೀ. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಆ್ಯನ್ ಅರಿಥಮೆಟಿಕ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರೆಷನ್. ಅದೇ ಡೆಫಿನಿಷನ್ ಹೇಳೋದು ಅದೇ ರೀ, AAB is an arithmetic progression. So now the natural question that arises is, can we insert more than one number between the two numbers? ಇಲ್ಲಿ 4 ಮತ್ತು 16 ಕೊಟ್ಟನ ನಾವು ಒನ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಇನ್ಸರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿರಿ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದರಿಗಿಂತ ಹೆಚ್ಚಿಗೆ ನಂಬರ್ ನಾವು ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ಸರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದೇನು? ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ನಾವು. ಎಸ್, ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಇನ್ಸರ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಮೆನಿ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ದ ಟೂ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಅದರ್ ವೇ ಈಸ್ 4, 8, 12, 16. ಸೊ ನಾವು ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ 4 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ 16 ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಇನ್ಸರ್ಟ್ ಟೂ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ 8 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ 12. These two are the arithmetic means. So now 8 minus 4, it is 4. 12 minus 8, it is 4. 16 minus 12, it is 4. Andra, difference same barthadare. So overall, what we have understood here, we can insert more than one number or we can insert as many numbers as possible between the given two numbers so that it forms an arithmetic progression. So this is all about the arithmetic mean, and we have an important example problems on this concept. So let us solve that. Well, the example problem, it is insert 6 numbers between 3 and 24 such that the resulting sequence is an AP. So this is important for 3 marks. Let us solve this. So here I will take those 6 numbers as A1, A2, A3, A4, A5 and A6. So here let the six numbers be A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, A6. So I am taking these, you know, 6 numbers such that now 3, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, A6, 24. So now this is in arithmetic progression such that R in arithmetic progression. So here A, which is equals to 3, the first term it is 3, then small b, it is 24, or it is also called the last term of an arithmetic progression, b, which is equals to 24, and then n value, it is 8, number of terms. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Overall, you have 8 terms. So, you know the formula. So, an, which is equals to a plus n minus 1 into d. So, here, an which is equals to a plus n minus 1 into d. So, what is an here? It is b. Andra, ide 24, an actually 24. Which is equals to a, that is 3, plus n minus 1, it is 8 minus 1 into d. So now 24, which is equals to 3 plus 7d, 8 minus 1 under 7 after 7d. Now take 3 to the LHS, it becomes minus 3. So 24 minus 3 is equals to 7d. 24 minus 3 under 21 after 21 equal to 7d. Or 7d equal to 21. So what is the value of d now? Andra 7 e kade tore 21 by 7 akta. It goes to the denominator. So 21 by 7 will be 3. Overall, the common difference, it is going to be 3. Now, with the help of the first term and the common difference, we can find a1 to a6. This is a1 to a6. So here. A1 which is equals to A plus D. Bari bodri itara. So this is A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D, A plus 4D, A plus 5D, A plus 6D and A plus 7D. So now A plus D, which is equals to A andre another 3 adha. Plus 3, it is 6. So we have calculated A1. Now A2 which is equals to A plus 2D. So A andra 3 adha, plus 2 into D andra 2 into 3 andra 6 akthare. So it is 9. Then so now A3 which is equals to A plus 3D. So A, it is 3 plus 3D andre 3 into 3 it is 9 so 9 plus 3 will be 12 then A4 which is equals to A plus 4D this is equals to 3 plus 4 into 3 it is 12 so you get 15 so now A5 which is equals to A plus 5D which is equals to 3 plus 5 into 3 it is 15 so overall it is 18 overall it is 18 and then A6 will be A6 which is equals to A plus 6D so 3 plus 6 into 3 it is 18 that will be equal to 21 that will be equal to 21 so what are the six numbers now 6 9 12 15 18 and 21 that we have to write now therefore the six numbers are therefore the six numbers the six numbers are 6 comma 9 comma 12 comma 15 comma 18 comma 21 so these are the six numbers that you can insert between 3 and 24 such that it forms an arithmetic progression this is all about the example problem in tomorrow's class we'll start with the exercise 9.2